Welcome to another session of Business Studies with me, Vishwanath sir. Hi, and we are in a revision mode where we shall be revising the chapter Nature and Significance of Management. In the last turn when we did, we went through what is management, what was a definition of management, and we also went through that management is a process, and we went through two important terms, efficiency and effectiveness. Okay, so combined all these things together makes management work properly. Okay, so today we first will start off with the functions of management. Okay, basically the functions of management are divided into planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. Okay, so the first let's discuss planning. And the planning basically is we decide in advance what to do, okay, how much to do. This place basically means that you try and see that your goals are set in advance, and in a way of developing them by achieving it, doing it effectively and efficiently. Planning is defined as setting objectives for a given period of time, formulating the various courses of action to achieve them, and then selecting the best possible alternative among the various courses of action which is available. It must be noted that the planning cannot prevent problems, but of course what will they do? They will reduce the problems. What? Because why? You are getting prepared well in advance about when things are going to come. So it is a good thing that you are planning, but of course it will never guarantee you, it's not that it is going to guarantee you success every time. So this is the first function of management. The first function of management is planning. Let's come to the second function. The second function is organizing. Organizing is a management function of assigning duties, grouping tasks, establishing authority and allocating the resources required to carry out a specific plan. Okay, so organizing, the basic meaning is how do you get things together, how do you do up an event, you organize an event, you organize a party, you organize a function. So once a specific plan has been established, so you set a plan, okay, then it has to be implemented. It has to be implemented with the given resources. So organizing basically involves grouping of the individual tasks into manageable departments or work units. So whoever can do a certain work properly, they are given that particular department to do so. So that is organizing for you. Then we have got staffing. Staffing simply means finding the right people for the right job. Okay, so it is very important that you have good staff, and the staff which can see you through at any times. Okay, because there are many people who shirk away from hard work. The moment additional pressure comes on them, they might quit the particular job also. So staffing function basically is concerned with obtaining, utilizing and maintaining a satisfactory and satisfied workforce. Okay, so the workforce has to be good. Fine, a good workforce can take a particular organization right to the top, but a bad workforce can bring it down very, 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 very easily and steadily. So an important aspect of management is to make sure that the right people with the right qualifications are available at the right place to accomplish the goals of an organization. This is known as human resource function, and it involves recruitment, selection, placement and training of the personnel. Okay, so first was planning, second was organizing, then we discussed staffing. Now let's come to the fourth one. The fourth one is directing. Directing involves leading and influencing and motivating people to perform the job which is assigned to them. Okay, you're giving the directions. Okay, the word directing comes from the word directions. So you're giving the directions. And a direction has got basically four elements, that is motivation, leadership, communication and supervision. Okay, so these are the four elements of directing, and motivation and leadership are two key components of direction. Okay, and motivating workers simply means that creating an environment, you are giving them enough amount of boost, energy you are giving them, so that they work towards the betterment of an organization. Leadership is influencing the others to do what a leader wants to do. A good manager directs through praise and criticisms in a way that they bring out the best in the employee. Directing also involves communicating effectively as well as supervising the employees at work. It is not just giving them the task. You have to see to it they do it properly. Okay, so that was directing for you. So far we discussed planning, organizing, staffing and directing. Let's come to the last function of management, that is controlling. Controlling is a management function of monitoring the organizational performance towards the attainment of the organizational goals. So an important word comes here, that is monitoring. So you are monitoring whether the task has been achieved or no, whether the task has given shape or the units which have to be produced are produced or no, and what is the hindrances which is coming in the way, and you have to find out why these obstacles or hurdles are blocking the progress of a particular organization. So the task of controlling involves establishing standards of performance. So you set a standard that today 100 units have to be produced. You measure the current performance and compare it with the established standards. So if the established standards is 105 or 110, so that is a standard. And then why a person is not achieving? Why a person is not achieving? So this means that you have to take corrective action in regard to the deviation. Okay, deviation means you are not achieving the exact target. There is a difference. Fine, so this is controlling for you. So just a repeat of the five functions. It's planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So these are the functions. And these are, later on you will realize that each one of them are different chapters which you have to do: planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. And you have to see it with the outside scenario also, okay? So when you are planning, you have to plan in such a way that you are better than your competitors, okay? And you achieve more targets and your profits increase at a steady rate. So the planning is a very essential process. Anything, for anything, you might plan for a party, you might plan for a function, you might plan for an event. So everything has to be done in the proper way. Okay, from here then we go to what is known as organizing. Organizing is basically getting all the resources intact and properly. Okay, getting them properly, grouping them, giving them additional tasks to do and so on. Staffing means finding the right people for doing the right job. So if you have the wrong persons in your organization, they are more likely to bring the organization down rather than lift it up. Okay, then you have directing, and directing is a very important process because here is where the directions are given to the workers, and we know that it consists of four elements, that is motivation, leadership, communication and supervision. Okay, and besides this you have got controlling. Controlling is another very important aspect because we learn that why the deviations are caused, okay, and how do you mold these deviations and get them in the right track. Okay, so it's important for us to know the meaning of each of these functions and each of these functions, what they perform and how it is important. Along with this we learn another word later on, which is known as coordination, because all these things, all these functions have to be coordinated properly. They have to go as per a particular particular hierarchy, particular motion, function altogether, so that it is better for the society to achieve greater amount of results. Okay, so this was the functions of management which you need to know thoroughly. And after we finish with this functions of management, we shall shift our focus towards the characteristics of or features of management. Okay, so now please go through these particular pointers properly, and of course you need not need to worry, because these are going to be repeated chapters. This each function is a repeated chapter later on after chapter number 3. Okay, please do revise. This is Vishwanath sir signing off. Thank you so much.